Now, your First Alert weather with meteorologist Michael Coates.
All right, live, actually not a live look right now. We had a picture of the sky cam. The sun was setting. It's going to be a beautiful, quiet evening here, but we expect to see a little more snow and rain trying to get in here for your Wednesday. We have a long way to go, though. We are coming in way short of our snowpack numbers so far for the year. Of course, we got a lot of winter to go, a lot of the snow season, but I just wanted to kind of show you some of these snow numbers. And you can see we have, especially in the Big Lost, and Little Wood basins, we're into the 50 and 60 percentile range, and that's really low. We are a little bit nicer in the Henry's Basin and the Snake Basin into the 80 percentile, but we would really love to see these numbers closer to 100%. That's the average for this time of the year. So the snow water numbers are down so far, but again, we're hoping that we can get some good storms in here, but the last few storms we've seen, we haven't pulled in a lot of snow, and we're expecting to see another storm in here starting tomorrow for central Idaho and for the rest of us on Wednesday. But this one's also looking to sputter out as it rolls inland, and it's not expected to dump in a whole lot of snow around here locally, even for our mountains. I want to show you here in the Vipercast areas of freezing fog for tonight and tomorrow morning. And then once you get free of the fog, we'll see partly cloudy skies. Then we get into tomorrow night about 5-6 o'clock. Snow and rain showers start getting into western and central Idaho. This is going to be a warmer storm. It's coming at us here from the southwest. That takes our highs well above freezing for the Snake River Plain, and that means we're going to see some rain and snow mixed in. And then as we go late night, Tuesday night into Wednesday, we have the possibility of seeing some snow getting into the Snake River Plain and the upper valley, plus some rain snow showers mixed for areas of the mid to lower Snake River Plain, but quite a bit of green and pink here on the map, and a lot of that moisture skipping right over areas of Idaho Falls, Rigby, Rexburg, Blackfoot, Pocatello for Wednesday. Wednesday morning rolls in, even some slushy accumulation amounts up towards Island Park and down through Driggs and Jackson with some snow very high up in elevation. And they'll have more of these passing showers throughout the day on Wednesday. And by 6 o'clock on Wednesday, the storm is departing with just some lingering pockets of mountain snow. Snowfall amounts are looking very thin with this storm. So again, don't expect to see a lot of snow with this system. We could pull in about 1 to 2 inches in Island Park, and that's about it. Some good snow in central Idaho once you go west of Stanley into the wilderness, but we're not expected to see a ton of snow. It's going to be more of a nuisance storm that comes in with temperatures warming into 30s and 40s, but a lot of wind to come along with that front. The winds will start picking up just a bit here for tomorrow, with the winds at around the really calm conditions in Idaho Falls, but around Pocatello, Blackfoot, and Burley, we'll see again the winds starting to pick up just a little bit here for tomorrow, and then the winds really crank up for everybody as we head into Wednesday with those teens and 20s for sustained wind speeds, gusts around 30. So for tonight, we're going to have areas of freezing fog. From that fog, slight chance of snowflakes. We have rain and snow on the way for Wednesday, and then gusty winds and warmer temperatures with that storm on Wednesday, with cold temperatures for Thursday and Friday. Lows tonight back into the teens and single digits for the valleys. Areas of western Wyoming, though, going sub-zero, like Afton at -4 tonight, -5 tonight in Jackson, 0 for Driggs, with a 7 in Rexburg tonight, and highs in around central Idaho into the 30s tomorrow, with lows into the single digits tonight in the teens around Salmon. We've got 7 for the low in Idaho Falls, 10 in Blackfoot, 11 in Pocatello, and 19 in Burley tonight, with highs into the 30s tomorrow. The winds will pick up on Wednesday, temperatures leaping to 40 degrees on Wednesday before the cold front slides through, and then the cold front leaves us with highs falling back below freezing for Thursday with a high of 29 in Idaho Falls. This weekend, mostly cloudy once again with a slight chance of snow, almost like what we saw this past weekend. Pocatello, 34 makes up the high for the high tomorrow, then 44 for the high on Wednesday, 37 for the high on Thursday. Blackfoot into the 30s for tomorrow, 40s for Wednesday, back down to the 30s for Thursday and Friday, with partly to mostly cloudy skies to get us through the weekend. Rexburg, a chance of snow in the forecast here for Wednesday. Could see a bit of accumulation, but also some melting, with highs very close to 40 for Wednesday afternoon and some gusty winds out of the southwest. Salmon, highs around 37 for tomorrow, with showers coming through here for Tuesday evening, showers for Wednesday with a rain snow mix, and then cold, partly sunny skies on Thursday. Jackson, you're looking to pick up on some snow, but again, the storm doesn't look like it's going to be a major winter storm. Just a hint of snow here and there, especially on the ski slopes and on those mountain peaks. And areas like the Teton Pass could be especially messy. Our John Adams GMC Spirit of Idaho comes to us from Emmett and Pocatello, but this wasn't taken in Pocatello, obviously. This was taken up in Sun Valley. So you know it's not a good winter when you live in Pocatello and you actually have to drive to see the snow like this. So he went up to Sun Valley, saw some good snow.
Looks like giant cakes. Look how deep that is on that picnic table.
Yeah, almost looks like a hostess.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, it's like a snowball.
Must be dinner time or something. Huh, puffy, fluffy stuff, pretty deep. All right, Dylan, Boise State picked their new head football coach last time we spoke.
Yeah, Andy Avalos is back in Boise to take over the Bronco football program. We will hear from him